John Dee was born July 13th, 1527, and lived to be 81 years old. He claimed descent from Roderick the Great, a Prince of Wales. His mother's name was Jane, and his father, Roland Dee, was a known vintner, or gentleman sower, of the worshipful company of mercers, or merchants, in service to Henry VIII. Roland and Jane took 10-year-old Dee out of London public school and sent him to Chantry School, Chelmsford, in Essex. At about 15 years old, Dee begins St. John's College in Cambridge, 1542 to 1548. From 1542 to 1545, he received his Bachelor of Arts studying Greek under John Cheek, Elizabeth I's personal tutor. In 1546, he became a founding fellow of Trinity College just before the death of Henry VIII. For Aristophanes' play, The Peace, Dee created a flying deus ex machina. At this time, he tutored a young Robert Dudley, Elizabeth I's favorite, and was paid by the Duchess of Northumberland. In 1548, he received his Master's of Arts as a Greek language teacher's assistant. From 1548 to 1551, Dee attended the Catholic University of Louvain in Belgium and studied civil law, geography, math, and there met Gemma Frisius, 1508 to 1555, a cartographer, Gerardus Mercator, 1512 to 1594, the first globe maker, Abraham Ortelius, 1527 to 1598, the cartographer to Philip II of Spain and Antwerp, and Matthias Harker, musician in Brussels. It was during his time at Louvain that Dee translated Euclid's 13 Elements, which was later published with intro and notes by Dee as the 1570 Billingsley edition. In 1551, Dee lectured in Reims, Paris, and declined an offer by Charles V to become a professor at Sorbonne. In 1552, John Dee returned to England. John Cheek's brother-in-law, William Cecil, introduced Dee to Edward VI, who was then king. Dee was granted a 100 crown per year pension by Edward VI and tutored the Earl of Pembroke and John Dudley, the Duke of Northumberland. In 1552, Dee founded the Society of the New Art. In Limehouse on Thames, Dee studied the smoking mirror of Tezcatlipoca with Humphrey Gilbert, 1539 to 1583, the half-brother of Walter Riley, who founded Newfoundland, Adrian Gilbert, years unknown, an alchemist, William Cecil, 1520 to 1598, Elizabeth I's chief advisor as Secretary of State from 1550 to 53 and from 1558 to 72, as well as Robert Dudley, 1532 to 1588, Elizabeth I's favorite lover, who killed his wife, Amy Robsart, in 1560, as well as Girolamo Cardano, 1501 to 1576, who was the inventor of the combination lock and the gimbal, the three concentric rings supporting a compass or gyroscope, and whom also studied probabilities. In 1553, John Dee's patron, John Dudley, the Duke of Northumberland and the father of Robert Dudley, was beheaded by Bloody Mary for crowning Lady Jane Grey. In that year, Dee traded his pension for rectorship of Upton-upon-Severn in Worcestershire. In the same year, Roland Dee was arrested by Bloody Mary as a prominent Protestant, and his assets were liquidated. In 1554, Girolamo Cardano cast the horoscope of Jesus, and John Dee studied astrology. Dee was acting as a secret messenger between Robert Dudley in the Tower of England and Elizabeth I under home arrest at Woodstock, and for his service was offered a readership in mathematics at Oxford, which he declined. In 1555, Roland Dee died, and John Dee inherited his father's stock in the Worshipful Company of Mercers, a livery company of London, with power to elect the Lord Mayor of London. Following this, Dee became a founding member of the Muscovy Company with Sebastian Cabot for Russian trade. At that time, he was falsely accused of necromancy by George Ferries, whom had Catholic connections, and arrested for calculating, confined at Hampton Court Palace, and on August 29th of 1555, Dee was examined before the Secretary of State, afterwards upon 18 articles by the Privy Council, and at last brought into the Star Chamber for trial, where he was cleared of all suspicion of treason and set free by order in council. However, the following November 19th of 1555, he was brought again before Bloody Bishop Edmund Bonner, 1500 to 1569, killer of an estimated 120 to 300 Protestants, and questioned by John Philpot. Dee quoted St. Cyprian, perhaps recalling the story of Bartholet Green, a fellow prisoner burnt for heresy. Philpot replies, "Master Dee, you are too young in divinity to teach me in the matters of my faith, though you be more learned in other things." In 1556, John Dee proposes a national library to Bloody Mary to preserve Catholic books burnt during the dissolution of the monasteries from 1536 to 1541. In 1557, Dee creates the paradoxical compass from the smoking mirror. In 1558, the same year as the first printing of the Zohar, Dee writes his first book, Propadumata Aphoristica, a treatise on astrology. In November of 1558, Bloody Mary Tudor died, and Elizabeth I succeeded the throne. Elizabeth asked Dee personally to choose her coronation date, which he selected as January 15th, 1559. Later that year, Leonard Diggs, the inventor of the telescope, died, and passes wardenship of his son, Thomas, to Dr. Dee. In 1562, in Antwerp, John Dee met with William Silvius, a printer, and in 1563, Dee traveled to Urbino and Rome. In 1564, Dee met proto-family of love cultists in Hungary. Johann Rademacher recommended him a book in the shop of Arnold Berkman. This book was Stenographia in three volumes. written in 1499 and blacklisted from 1609. The third volume was not published until 1606, and later used as the cipher manuscripts by the Golden Dawn. The book described cryptographic depiction using spirits to communicate over very long distances, and was by Abbe Johann Trithemius, 1462 to 1516, who was the teacher of both Henry Cornelius Agrippa and Paracelsus. Immediately after reading Steganographia, John Dee wrote the Monus Hieroglyphica and dedicated it to the newly coronated Holy Roman Emperor Maximilian II, a Habsburg. The Monus was written in Antwerp and took 13 days to write, from January 13th to the 24th, and it was published by Sylvius in March of 1564. At that time, John Dee was 37 years old, the same age as Maximilian II, and it was in that July that Maximilian II, 1527 to 1576, was made the King of Hungary, Bohemia, and the Holy Roman Empire. In 1565, Dee returned to London, and in 1566 he obtained the rectorship of Long Leadenham in Lincolnshire. In that year he moved to Mortlake with his mother Jane and began his library of 3,000 plus scrolls and 1,000 plus bound books. 1567, Dee took copious notes on Vitruvius De Architectura, and Roger Cook became John Dee's apprentice. In 1568, Dee published Propadeutica Aphoristica, dedicated to Elizabeth I, and began math lessons for Elizabeth. In 1570, Dee published the preface to Lord Mayor of London Henry Billingsley's edition of Euclid, in which Dee mentions his smoking mirror of Tezcatlipoca. Later in that year, Dee was sent to the Duchy of Lorraine by Elizabeth I, and in 1571 returned, however was ill. He was treated by Elizabeth I's own doctors, Astlow and Balthrop. The following year, 1572, Tycho Brahe observed a supernova, and Isaac Luria died. In 1573, Nicholas Barnard, 1538-1604, of Huguenot France, advocated tyrannicide, the killing of a king. The following year, 1574, John Dee married his first wife, who, however, in 1575, died. The day of his wife's death, Elizabeth I visited John Dee at Mortlake. However, she said she won't come in with death in the house, and instead of his vast library, only examined John Dee's smoking mirror in a nearby field. In 1576, Thomas Diggs, John Dee's ward, published a new edition of his father's perpetual almanac called Prognostication Everlasting, including an appendix about then-new Copernican heliocentrism. In 1577, January, John Dee was visited at Mortlake by Robert Dudley, William Sidney, who was then treasurer, and Edward Dyer, the alchemist. And in March, Abraham Ortelius, the Dutch cartographer of Spain. In August, Dee published the General and Rare Memorials Pertaining to the Perfect Art of Navigation for the Muscovy Company, and also made a catalog of maps used to study by the Gilberts, Davis, Hawkins, Frobisher, etc., and coined the term British Empire. In 1578, John Dee married Jane Fremond, a 23-year-old lady-in-waiting of Lady Howard of Effingham. In September, Elizabeth I fell ill, and in November, Dudley and Walsingham sent Dee to Berlin to fetch a Dr. Turnifer. In 1579, from June 15th to October 31st, Dee's mother left him Mortlake, and on July 13th, his first son of 8 children was born, Arthur Dee, and his wife Jane Fremond's father died. In 1580, October the 10th, came the death of John Dee's mother, Jane, and brought another visit from Elizabeth I. During that year, Dee was making maps of Atlantis, Roger Bacon's name for America, and in the following year of 1581, on June 7th, John Dee's first daughter was born, named Catherine Dee. That year, Roger Cook, who had been an apprentice to Dee for 14 years, quit due to jealousy, although he would return as Dee's secretary from 1605 to 1609, when Dee was old and dying at Mortlake. In 1582, Dee worked briefly with scryer Barnabas Saul, and 2 days later would meet Edward Kelly. In 1583, John Dee published his great work on calendar reform, called A Plain Discourse and Humble Advice for Our Gracious Queen Elizabeth, Her Most Excellent Majesty, to peruse and consider as concerning the needful reformation of the vulgar calendar for the civil years and days accompting or verifying according to the time truly spent. This suggested adding 11 rather than 10 days to correct to Christ's birthday rather than the Papal Council of Nicaea date, although casting Christ's horoscope was officially illegal at that time. Ultimately, Dee's proposals for calendar reform were rejected by the bishops and lords alike, and simultaneously, Dee missed the deadline to get the grant for his two rectories from Bishop Grindal renewed. In 1583, John Dee and Edward Kelly met Albert Lasky and returned with him to Poland. Lasky turned out to be a spy for Jesuit-favoring, recently elected King of Poland, Stephen Bathory, who was securing at that time the Peace of Jamzapolski in 1582 with Ivan the Terrible, the first Tsar of Russia. In 1584, John Dee and Edward Kelly met with Holy Roman Emperor Rudolf II, the son of Maximilian II, the Holy Roman Emperor and King of Bohemia. He was the patron of Tycho Brahe, and for whom Nostradamus had once cast a horoscope. John Dee gave Holy Roman Emperor Rudolf II his copy of the Voynich manuscript. It is speculated that the following year, in 1585, Dee and Kelly met Thaddeus Hayek, Anselmus de Boot, and Nicholas Bernard in Prague. From 1585 until 1589, Dee and Kelly were in Prague, Bohemia, Leipzig, Saxony and Germany, and Trebona in southern Bohemia. In 1585, in Krakow, Poland, Dee and Edward Kelly met Francesco Pucci. It is speculated that in 1587, Dee and Kelly met with Rabbi Judah Lowe, the Maharal, in Prague, who had created a golem. In 1589, John Dee and Edward Kelly met with Heinrich Kunrath in the court of Rudolf II at Prague in Bohemia. And in the same year, John Dee split from Edward Kelly and returned to England to find Mortlake burglarized, his library almost gone. In 1593, Elizabeth I made John Dee the warden of Christ's College in Manchester, which had been re-established in 1578. In 1603, Elizabeth I died, and her throne passed to James VI of Scotland, who became James I of England. In 1605, John Dee returned to Mortlake, and Roger Cook returned as his secretary. In 1609, John Dee died penniless.